गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। माई नेम इज आर्यन किरण एंड नाउ आई एम गोना एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द टॉपिक इन बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग कॉल्ड टू फेस सर्वो मोटर एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन। नाउ लेट अस सी इन डिटेल व्हाट इज टू फेस सर्वो मोटर एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन। फर्स्ट लेट अस सी इन डिटेल व्हाट इज कॉल्ड ए सर्वो मोटर। सर्वो मोटर आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड कंट्रोल मोटर। दे आर यूज इन फीडबैक कंट्रोल सिस्टम एज आउटपुट एक्यूरेटर्स एंड डज नॉट यूज फॉर कंटिन्यूस एनर्जी कन्वर्शन। The principle of the servo motor is similar to that of other electromagnetic motor, but the construction and the operation are different. Their power ratings varies from a fraction of watt to a few hundred watts. The rotor inertia of the motor is low and have a high speed of response. The rotor of the motor has the long length and small diameter. They operate at very low speed and sometimes even at the zero speed. The servo motor is widely used in radar, computers, robots, machine tools, tracking and guidance system, processing, controlling, etc. Now let us see what are the classification of a servo motor. Basically, servo motors are classified into AC and DC servo motor. The AC servo motor is further divided into two categories, that is two phase AC servo motor and three phase AC servo motor. With the help of this diagram, we can able to see that types of servo motor are AC servo motor and DC servo motor. And AC servo motor is divided into two, that is two phase AC servo motor and three phase AC servo motor. Now let us see in detail what is two phase AC servo motor. The stator of the two phase AC servo motor has two distributed windings which are displaced from each other by 90 degrees electrical, which can be seen here in the diagram. This is the two phase AC servo motor windings. Here is the first one and here is the second one. Okay. Now one winding is known as reference or fixed phase. This is the reference. This winding is known as reference or fixed phase, which is supplied from a constant voltage source. The other one is known as control phase and it is provided with a variable voltage. Here is the control phase and it is provided with a variable voltage. The connection diagram of this two phase AC servo motor is given below. Here you can see one winding is called control phase and one winding is called reference phase, which are both inclined at an angle 90 degrees and which are kept in between high resistance cage rotor is kept. Now let us see the graph between torque and speed of a servo motor. The control phase servo phase is usually supplied from a servo amplifier. The speed and torque of the rotor are controlled by the phase difference between the control voltage and the reference phase voltage. By reversing the phase difference from leading to lagging or vice versa, the direction of the rotation of the rotor can be reversed. Here we can also reverse the direction of the rotation of the rotor by using servo motor. The torque speed characteristics of two phase AC servo motor is given below. Here it is the torque speed characteristics of two phase AC servo motor, which from the graph we can see that on x axis we have taken speed and on y axis we have taken the torque speed of the servo motor, and these are the values we got as the values we got as VA is equal to 1 PU and VA is equal to 0.7 P micro units and at last 0.0 micro units. Now let us see in detail what are the applications of a servo motor. The power rating of the servo motor may vary from the fraction of watts to a few hundred of watts. The rotor of servo motor have low inertia strength and therefore they have a high speed of inertia. The applications of servo motor can be seen as follows. Servo motors are used in radar systems and process controller. Radar systems are widely used in military camps or people who fight for their country so that they can know whether enemy is going to attack them or not at the current time. By using radar system, we can know whether someone is going to attack on our country or not. In this radar system and process controller, servo motors are also used. Servo motors are also used in computers and robotics. We can see in our day-to-day life, the use of computers and robotic technology is increasing day by day. So there is a great increase in the market value of servo motors. So servo motors are also used in computers and robotics in a widely range across the globe. They are also used in machine tools. Servo motors are also used in machine tools to repair something or to get something constructed or built. They have a very wide use in the machinery tools era. Tracking and guidance system. Servo motors are also used in tracking and guidance systems for the tourist or as well as for the people who lost their way. Servo motors can be used for tracking and guidance system. So in this way, from the previous slides, we came to know about what are servo motors and what are its classifications, that is two-phase AC servo motor and three-phase servo motor. And the main topic of the class is two-phase AC servo motor. And we came to know what is two-phase AC servo motor and what is its actual diagram, that is control phase and reference phase and high resistance gauge rotor, and what is the graph of AC servo motor and what are its application. So with this, I will end my session. Thank you.